lesson, we will make a scoring app, and using a scoring app, we will learn more about layouts and also about app icon. So what I have open on my screen is the default project that gets created in Android Studio. And the first thing I'm going to do is delete the Hello World text box. Now on this empty screen, we will add a layout, and we will add a linear layout horizontal. So I have added a linear layout horizontal. The height of it I will set to wrap content, and its width we will set to fill underscore pair. So that is what we will set its height and width to for this. Now within this, because it's a scoring app, we will divide the screen into two parts. So the left side will be for team A and the right side will be for team B. So what do? We will add two linear layout verticals within this linear layout horizontal, which represents team A and team B. And the width for this we will give as wrap content, and the height will be match parent. Same thing for the second linear layout. We will do wrap content as the width and match parent as the height. The other thing we will do here is a piece called layout underscore weight. So what we will do in the layout underscore weight is set it to 1 in both the cases. So what it means is that when we do it as set to 1, now this is a common mistake that happens. So I'll again switch it back to my portrait and have gotten it. So at times, because of some selection, our editor or the device we were setting it in just goes out, so you can set it back. So we were talking about the layout. So I have set layout weight as 1 for both the linear layout vertical, which means if there is any space, they will occupy 50-50%. If their weights are the same, they will occupy similar space. So which means I have set it to 1 so that they fill the screen, but they occupy half of it. So that is the function of a weight. Now within this, we need to add a text box to show the score. So I'll add a text view within the linear layout vertical, the first one, and I will add a text view within the second one. So I have a text view in both the cases. Let's say we call the text here as T1 in the first text. And what do? Because we want to see it as a scoreboard, let's increase the font size. So we will go to text size. So here is text size, and let's set it to be a reasonably large font size. So let me set it as 60 SP. Second, we want it to be in the center. So we will go to text alignment and we will set it as center. This is what we have done here. Same thing in the text view 4 we will do. We will go to text size and set it to again 60 SP. The second thing we will do is set its alignment to center, and within the text view we will make it T2. So now both our text views have been designed. Now we want to add a couple of buttons below it so that they will help us score. So let's go to all and buttons, and let me put a button here and another button. So I have my two buttons in my first layout. Similarly, I'll put two buttons for team 2. So these are my two buttons on both sides. So let's call this button that if we press this button, 1 gets printed on the screen, and if we press this button, it says 2. Now we want some more properties on these buttons. So let us see how we will use it. So suppose we want these buttons to be slightly more centered. So let's give them a layout margin. So let me say I will give it a 30 dp layout margin. So you can see this has created margins on all sides of it of 30 size. Same thing I will do to the other button. I will give it a 30 dp margin. Button 3 and 4, again we will do the same thing so that they look the same. And for button 4, again, I will do the same. So you can see the layout is starting to look much, much better. And I will change the text for button 3 and also for button 4. So now my simple design is over. So you can see how the design looks like. And now we can go and code it within the app. And what can we code within the app? In the app, we will code that when we press 1, 1 gets printed here. When we press 2, it shows 2 here. Same for the T2 side of it. So let's go to mainActivity.java. Now what do we need to do? We need to first declare the components that we have used. So we have used a text view. So let's declare the two text views, call them say TV1 and TV2. We have used two text views and we have used buttons. How many buttons have we used? We have used two buttons. So B11 for the and B12 for team 1 and B21 and B22 for team 2. So we have used four buttons and two text views. So now we will need to initialize them. So TV1 is equal to text view, find view by ID. Let's just look at the IDs for each one of them so that we can see them. So text view 3 and text view 4. Let's change them to say text view 1 and text view 2. So these are our two IDs, and for the buttons, let's make them button 11, button 12, and for the team 2, let's make them button 21 and button 22, so that it is easier for us to remember. That we have made these changes, let's go back. So we will do r.id.textview1. Same for the second text view, for team 2, text view, find view by ID, r.id.textview2. So we have initialized our two text views, now we need to initialize the buttons. So B11 is equal to button, find view by ID, r.id.button11. B12 is equal to button, find view by ID, r.id.button12. So now we need to initialize button 21 and 22. So we will do that the same way. Find view by ID, r.id.button21. And the last button, B22. Find view by ID, r.id.button22. Now that we have initialized our four buttons and the two text views, what do we need to do? We need to handle the onClick event. So B11.setOnClickListener, and what do we do here? New view onClickListener, and what should we do here? We will set TV1.setText. Let's go back to the screen. So we have, if we press this button, 1 should be printed, and if we press 2, 2 should be printed. So what we do, we will set text as say 1. In B12.setOnClickListener, what would we do? We will say TV1.setText2. So we have set up our two listeners for team 1. Now we need to set it up for team 2. Set listener, new view. And in this case, it will be TV2.setText1. And similarly for the last button, B22.setOnClickListener, new, and TV2.setText. And what text will we set to? And with this, our coding is complete. So now let us run this application. So we will start running this application. It'll take a little bit of time to build. The Gradle build is running, you can see that. And we will pull up our emulator. Let the build happen. So be patient. takes a little bit of time for the build, so just be patient. The build is over and now it is installing the APKs. And the app has come up on our screen. So we can see T1, T2 and the two buttons 1-1 and 2-2. And look at the layout. It's completely half-half layout coming to both of them because we had set the layout weights to 1. Now when we click 1 or 2, we are getting the result we desired for. This is what we were looking for. So we have been able to make this app. Now let's do one more thing here. Now suppose I go to home and I see it, I am getting, so this was my scoreboard app. So this is the icon we are getting. Suppose I want to set up a new icon here. So how will I do it? I'll go to app, do a right click, new, and image asset. And let us say in the image asset, we will choose launcher icons that we are getting here, adaptive and legacy. And what we will go to the path and only choose a new icon. So we will just go where we want to put a new icon. And let me say just go to, and we have say scoreboard sbicon.jpg. So that is my icon and we just want to set it. So we will just click on next and we will do finish. So now our icon has been set. Now let's run the app and see whether the icon shows. So we're running the app and let us just pull the emulator up again and let us wait for the build to happen. Let's wait for the installation to happen. So you can see the icon has changed. It's the same app right now. And if I go back here, my icon has come up. So this is how we can set up an icon. So my icon has changed. Now we can play around with the graphics of this icon to see how to improve it. But this is how we would set up an icon also. Okay. So we've created a scoring app and we have been able to set an icon for it. Okay.